Thanks for joining us on the CBN News Channel. I'm Charlene Israel. Scientists are still scratching their heads over last week's cosmic coincidence. On Friday, the biggest meteor to hit Earth in more than 100 years struck Russia just hours before a massive asteroid made a close pass. The incident has scientists, the United Nations, and even Congress searching for better ways to identify asteroids that could threaten Earth.
The meteor that exploded over Russia carried the explosive force of 20 Hiroshima bombs. And only hours after the meteor hit Russia, a 150-foot asteroid missed Earth by only 17,000 miles. NASA says there was no connection between the two, but it raises the specter of the threat that asteroids can pose to Earth. Experts say this could be a cosmic warning shot and a reminder to continue to invest in space science.
20 years ago, if DA-14 flew by the Earth, we would have never known it.
The UN and the House Science, Space and Technology Committee announced plans to investigate the threat of asteroids to Earth. One former NASA astronaut is already developing a plan to detect asteroids. It's a deep space telescope called Sentinel, and it could give Earth decades of advance warning when something major is heading our way.
With 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 years of notice, it's actually pretty straightforward to deflect an asteroid.
Liu says his project will cost about $450 million. He's hoping to raise the money through public donations. And he says it's a small price you pay when you think of the alternative. Officials estimate it will cost over $33 million to repair damage from the Russian meteor.
How could we let our civilization or parts of our civilization or huge parts of our cities or whatever go away, be destroyed, if we could have done something about it?
Back in 2010, a National Research Council report called for Congress to provide more funds to find asteroids bigger than a football field. Well, winter weather is blasting much of the U.S. today. A dangerous new storm is causing problems from the Rockies to the Dakotas. And in New England, blizzard conditions hammered residents with heavy snow and powerful winds causing whiteout conditions Sunday. This new blast comes as many in the region are still recovering from that monster blizzard that buried some areas under 3 feet of snow. The doctor who made the keynote speech at the National Prayer Breakfast is still getting a lot of attention. Dr. Ben Carson spoke about taxes and health care in his address. So far, his speech has gotten more than 2 million views on YouTube and catapulted his book, America the Beautiful, to number 3 on Amazon. Critics say Carson's remarks were too political for a prayer breakfast. On ABC's This Week on Sunday, he said there's another reason for the strong reaction.
I make of it the fact that before I gave that talk, I prayed and asked God to give me wisdom, what to say, what would resonate, what would be important. And, I don't think it was particularly political.
When asked for his opinion on President Obama, Dr. Carson said he's a good politician. He also said that as far as getting into politics is concerned, I leave that up to God. The U.S. Justice Department says homeschooling is not a fundamental right. That's the argument they made in a federal court case against an evangelical Christian family from Germany, which is seeking asylum in the U.S. The Romeike family was forced to flee Germany or risk losing their 5 children. The German government was trying to force them to put their children in public school. U.S. Attorney General Eric Holder has filed against the family seeking to deport them. Holder is arguing that asylum should not be granted to homeschoolers, even if they claim their religious freedoms are being violated. And joining us now with more is Dr. Michael Donnelly, Director of International Affairs for the Homeschool Legal Defense Association. Thanks for joining us this morning.
Thank you, Charlene. Good to be with you this morning.
What is the status of the Romeike case?
Well, in 2010, an immigration judge granted the Romeikes asylum, and the United States government immediately appealed that. The case was then reviewed by the Board of Immigration Appeals, and that board reversed the immigration judge, saying or agreeing with the government that homeschooling was not a fundamental right and that homeschoolers were not a particular social group under the Asylum Act. We have then appealed that decision to the Sixth Circuit Court of Appeals and filed the remaining briefs just last week. We'll be waiting for the Sixth Circuit to issue an order for oral argument, we hope. It could be a year or more before we have a final answer.
And how likely are they to be deported back to Germany?
Well, in this environment, it doesn't appear that there's a whole lot of deportations going on. In fact, I understand that the Obama administration has created policies instructing the immigration officials to look at deporting those who have a criminal record. So I don't think the Romaikis are at any great risk of deportation right now, while we're waiting the outcome of their case, at least.
Okay, now, is the argument from the Justice Department dangerous for homeschool rights in America?
Well, we think it's instructive. Of course, this is an immigration case, and the Department of Justice has to take the opposite side and do their job. But we are troubled by the arguments made in the briefs by the government. They essentially say that it's okay for a country, even a democratic country, to actually ban all home education. They say that there's no problem with this because it's equally applied, which we would take issue with their view of the facts. But that's very troubling from our government to say that. We're concerned about it.
Definitely. Well, could this be the beginning of a serious pushback against homeschooling in the U.S. from the Obama administration?
Well, in our country, the states have the authority over education, and by God's grace, over the last 30 years, homeschooling has become legal in all 50 states in America. In fact, the things that are happening to German homeschoolers today happened to American homeschoolers 30 years ago, so we have to remember that that was the case and that persecution certainly can happen here. In the name of homogenizing a culture or people having different attitudes. But, you know, the federal government is very limited in its ability to affect home education. And so we hope that that won't be the case. But I'll tell you, we will be watching carefully, and we will be ready to respond if the federal government or any state government actually takes some steps to try to curtail home education in our country.
Definitely. Well, Connecticut is considering a law to allow monitoring of homeschool children. Is that a serious concern for homeschooling rights?
It certainly is. In fact, Connecticut is not alone in attempting to pass restrictive regulation on home educators across our country. But this one is particularly egregious, ordering that homeschoolers and public school children as well would undergo behavioral health assessments. This is very concerning, intruding, getting the government to intrude into families' lives this way is very concerning to us, whether it's homeschoolers or any children. It certainly isn't the place, we believe, for government to be looking at children's behavioral health, ordering psychological assessments or things of that nature.
Very interesting. We'll keep an eye on it. Michael Donnelly, thanks for joining us. We appreciate your insights.
Thank you.
Last week, President Obama launched a new push for universal pre-K in America. Some critics say the U.S. can't afford the price tag, but a leading Christian author and speaker believes the problem goes far beyond that. CBN's Lee Webbs recently spoke with R.C. Sproul Jr. He believes that as long as Christians continue to give their children to be trained by the state, we will continue to have a culture that worships the state.
That's my conviction that education is always and everywhere religious. And it's not a surprise that when 80% of evangelical parents have their children in the government's schools, that they're going to embrace the religion of the government, which is the worship of the state.
That's why Sproul believes Christians shouldn't have their kids in government schools. Christian missionary and evangelist T.L. Osborne has died. Once dubbed the father of the gospel, Osborne passed away on Thursday. His daughter posted news of his death on Twitter, saying he suffered no sickness or pain, that the Lord simply took his breath away. He started Osborne Ministries with his wife Daisy in 1949. Their ministry reached more than 100 nations, with meetings drawing up to 300,000 people. He lived by the motto, one way, Jesus, one job, evangelism. But he also experienced his share of grief. Three of his children died prematurely, and his wife Daisy died in his arms. He talked about that experience on the 700 Club.
Discouragement depression, oppression. It is a matter of the thoughts that we choose to retain. Mm-hmm. If we think depressing thoughts, we'll be depressed. I had to change my way of thinking. Instead of lamenting Daisy's death and being gone from me, I said to myself, wait, this isn't helping me and it won't help anybody else. So I changed my thoughts and remember. I drew from my memory bank and remembered when she was with me. Mm-hmm. And so I comfort myself. God comforts me, but you got to take control.
T.L. Osborne was 89 years old. Coming up, changing trends in global missions, how those who are spreading the gospel are taking on a new look and a new focus.
Today we're on a field trip to discover what inflation is doing to our paper money. In this hand is a $20 bill, and in this hand is a $20 U.S. gold coin. They used to have the same buying power, but how much can they buy today? In this first basket is what my $20 bill buys: milk, bread, peanut butter, and jelly. And here's what one $20 gold coin will buy: 6 baskets full, worth nearly $2,000, almost 100 times more food, simply by owning gold dollars instead of paper dollars. History shows that the gold coins have been the best way to beat the rising cost of living. So, class, the moral is that unless you want to live on peanut butter and jelly sandwiches in the future, you should turn some paper dollars into gold coins now. How and why is explained in a new book, The Great Debasement. Call the number below for a totally free copy. And that's the simple truth.
Help!
If an emergency happened right now, you can have help with the push of a button with Medical Alert.
Remember when I took that fall, Mary?
Oh, yes, that was terrible.
Yes, it was.
Help!
And I thought, what if you hadn't been there? I ordered my Medical Alert the next day.
I can't describe how safe I feel now with my Medical Alert. You didn't know I was wearing it, did you?
Medical Alert is easy to install, waterproof, and covers you inside your home and out.
It helps me feel safe from fires, break-ins.
And of course, a Medical Alert. And if you don't have a home phone, don't worry. They have that covered.
There's always help at the push of a button. Don't wait till you need it.
Get Medical Alert for less than a dollar a day. There are no long-term contracts. Order now and get your second button free. Call for your free brochure.
For your free Medical Alert system with second button free, call 800-575-8507.
Four foreign Christian workers in Libya have been arrested on suspicion of spreading Christianity and giving out Christian literature. Preaching the gospel is against the law in the mostly Muslim nation. A police spokesman says one of the suspects is a Swedish-American. The others are from South Africa, Egypt, and South Korea. Police arrested them Tuesday and confiscated some 45,000 books in their possession. Another 25,000 books were reportedly distributed. The face of global missions is changing. It used to be Western churches that launched the majority of missionaries throughout the world. Now, most missionaries are being sent from Latin America, Asia, and Africa. The focus of missions work has also changed to the 10,000 cultural groups which are still considered unreached by the gospel. Most of these groups are located in the 1040 window, the regions of Africa and Asia, between 10 and 40 degrees latitude north of the equator. Dr. Tim Hill is the General Director of Church of God World Missions. He's also author of the book Beyond the Mist. Since last August, he's traveled to 12 countries, and he's seen some of the latest developments in Christianity and world missions. CBN's George Thomas talked with him about it.
Give us a glimpse of how God is moving today around the world.
Well, God is moving, and I see the map here of the 1040 window from Asia over to Africa, 10 to 40 degrees latitude north of the equator, where many of the unreached people groups are, and God is moving into those groups, some 7,000 of them that have never heard the name of Jesus Christ. We're seeing advances to touch their hearts for God, but now we're beginning to see a shift toward what is now known as the 414 window, which speaks specifically to young people and children who are very impressionable and very open to receiving the good news of the Lord Jesus Christ. And what is assisting us there is the explosion that we're seeing of missionaries coming literally from all over the world.
In fact, you refer them to, you know, this is the mission field, now that's becoming the mission force.
The mission force. Yeah. And I said on an earlier interview, the children have grown up. Where we have taken the gospel, where we have sown the seed, has now grown into a great harvest. And they're saying, we must now take the gospel. And the mission field has indeed become a mission force from Latin America and throughout.
Staggering fact that 80% of those who accept Christ do so before the age of 18. And amongst those, the majority of them have this experience with Christ between the ages of 4 and 14.
Four and 14.
Critical time period to share the gospel.
It's very crucial, and we must get to them through every means of technology, that we can find.
And there are places in the world today, you know this, whether it's Buddhists, Muslims, atheists, who don't know a single Christian. How is that possible? How do we reach them?
Well, we call them the unreached people groups, of which there are more than 7,000. There are 17,000 different groups around the world that speak a common language and have a common culture. To be unreached means that there are 2% or less of a Christian influence there. Mm-hmm. We reach them, first of all, by embracing them. We pray for them. We adopt them. Secondly, we engage them through a process of missionary work, training, loving on them. Finally, we enlist them so that they too become a part of the missionary calls and the evangelistic effort in their own nation, raising up indigenous people to become national workers and leaders among their own people is the key.
I remember George Ortiz one time saying that God goes where he is needed the most. Mm. Latin America, Africa, Asia is crying out for God. We don't see that happening too much in North America, in Europe, and so forth. What is the key to having an authentic revival take place today in North America, whether it's the United States or in Europe?
Well, it's very simple. It starts with falling back in love with Jesus. Jesus told the church at Ephesus, of your own free will, of your own volition, you have left your first love. He did not say, you don't love me at all. What he said was, you don't love me like you used to. And God is calling us back to a first love experience. And when that happens, revival begins. And A.W. Tozier made this statement, and I paraphrase, anything that does not change the culture and change the spiritual climate of a community, a nation, ultimately the world, is not realistic revival.
And what's amazing is that today, those who were the recipients of the gospel, whether in Latin America, Africa, Asia, have now a burden to come to our shores.
They are. They're coming to America from South Korea, from Latin America, from Asia. They're coming here to preach to us the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ.
And we should not be afraid about it.
Absolutely. Embrace it.
Fantastic. What encouraging news you bring to our viewers today around the world. Thank you so much, Dr. Hill.
Up next, the war over weed. So far, two states have legalized pot. Will others follow suit? We'll hear from both sides of the debate.
Attention, sleep apnea patients. Are you tired of the expense and hassle of getting your CPAP and BiPAP supplies? Are you fed up with dealing with ill-fitting, leaking, or worn-out masks and straps? Are you worried about the effects that unsanitary tubes, cushions, and filters have on your health? If you said yes to any of these questions, Allied Medical Supply Network has the solution to your problems. You could qualify to have your supplies regularly delivered right to your door at little or no cost to you. That's right, no more inconvenience, no worn-out masks and straps, no more unsanitary equipment, just restful sleep. Call Allied Medical Supply Network today to determine if you may qualify to receive your fresh, brand-name supplies at little or no cost. Don't delay. Call us now to see if you are eligible to save money on regular delivery of your CPAP and BiPAP supplies. Call 1-800-815-9947. That's 1-800-815-9947. Or go to CPAPSupplyHelpline.com.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
A new study shows better TV equals better behavior among children. The study suggests that changing the channel from violent TV shows to education TV can improve the behavior of preschoolers. The study comes from the Seattle Children's Research Institute. It shows the improvement is modest and fades over time, but lead author Dr. Dimitri Christakis says it proves that what children watch is as important as now how much they watch. The legalization of marijuana in Colorado and Washington could lead other states to push for similar laws. But there's already growing concern about marijuana's impact on young people. They're more likely than adults to try it. And as Heather Sells shows us, they're also more likely to suffer from it.
Pot smokers have wasted no time in lighting up in select bars in Washington and Colorado. The two states are seen as leaders in a national movement to legalize marijuana. While advocates believe it would keep kids safer, opponents fear it could prove disastrous. Although marijuana is now legal in Colorado for those over 21, many believe that those under 21 will be able to access it more easily. And that's a concern because health-wise, marijuana poses a far greater threat for teens.
Some people think that marijuana is just psychologically addictive, not physically addictive. It's just a soft drug, something like that. But I can tell you from personal experience that these kids who come to see us are dropping out of life.
Psychiatrist Christian Thurstone directs one of Colorado's largest clinics for treating youth substance abuse. He's seen firsthand what the research shows, that one in six kids who try marijuana before age 18 become addicted. And lots of kids are trying. Two-thirds of new marijuana users each year are under 18. The worst part, their brains are significantly more vulnerable to the drug.
It's a time of enormous brain development. The very receptor that marijuana binds to in the brain is the receptor that helps control this brain development.
That means these young users can lose as many as 8 IQ points. They're 4 times more likely to do poorly in school and twice as likely to have a car accident. Colorado educators point to a possible link between the 2009 legalization of so-called medical marijuana and increased trouble in school. When medical marijuana dispensaries began popping up across the state, drug-related school suspensions and expulsions also spiked. But those who support legalization argue student use has gone down since 2009. They believe that regulation is the best way to protect kids.
Illegal marijuana dealers are not asking for proof of age. By taking it, putting it behind a counter, having really strict rules on selling to minors, we can better keep it out of their hands.
Tvert's organization, the Marijuana Policy Project, helped pay for and organize the Colorado and Washington legalization campaigns. It's now targeting 14 other states, but a new national organization is saying not so fast.
Why introduce another legal substance when we're already having a hard time with our currently legal ones?
Dr. Kevin Sabet advised both Presidents Bush and Obama on the drug problem. And although he agrees that our country is far too quick to criminalize marijuana users, he's not convinced that legalization is the answer.
The problem with it really is that it increases the permissiveness of a drug and it increases social acceptance.
Sabet is teaming up with Thurstone and two big names, former Congressman Patrick Kennedy, son of Ted Kennedy, and conservative writer David Frum. Their organization, Smart Approaches to Marijuana, or SAM, believes that legalization supporters have downplayed the risks of smoking pot.
This is not your Woodstock weed, you know. This is the marijuana that's much more harmful now in terms of its THC content.
But kids seem to have missed that message.
I don't think it's harmful at all.
And why don't you think it's dangerous?
Because it's a plant and you smoke it and it just gets you high.
I think one of the reasons kids think it's okay is that medical, so-called medical marijuana, has softened attitudes and people think, well, it's a medicine.
Thurstone also notes that much of this new research hasn't reached the public. In the meantime, there's a fear that big tobacco companies will get into the marijuana business and target youth, just like they did with cigarettes. Churches in Colorado are figuring out how to work with teens as the situation unfolds.
Anytime any drug becomes more readily available, we need to talk about it.
Brady Boyd is senior pastor at New Life, a mega church in Colorado Springs. He says believers there are concerned about just how legalization will play out, but he says they shouldn't miss the deeper issue.
And so we're talking internally about why are people so willing to medicate themselves? What pain are they running from? What are the issues that they are struggling with that causes them to go to things like marijuana?
No one knows just how Colorado will shape its regulations or how available marijuana will be starting next year. But what's clear is this. The nation will be watching, waiting to see what legalization means for communities and especially for their youth. Reporting in Denver, Heather Sells, CBN News.
An important message for those who have currently applied or are thinking about applying for a reverse mortgage. You've probably seen commercials with famous actors talking about reverse mortgages, telling you how you can eliminate your monthly mortgage payment, still own your home, and live the life of your dreams. Well, most of that is true, but you need the facts. Call now for our 7 secrets of reverse mortgages. This simple-to-read brochure includes information about possible hidden fees, which program benefits you and not the bank, and how to negotiate better terms. We'll give you facts that are easy to understand. You'll learn about the 5 most misleading claims that some lenders make. For example, that you can't lose your home with a reverse mortgage. The fact is, foreclosure may occur if you live somewhere other than the home for a period of time, or you fail to pay real estate taxes or insurance. You need to call to get the facts. Operators are standing by.
Call 1-888-842-6237 or visit our website now.
When you're driving along and your cell phone rings, do your eyes instantly go off the road? Then you need to get a grip. Hi, David Jones here with the new GripGo, the most versatile hands-free mount that will instantly grip any phone for safe driving. Just attach the suction cup to your windshield or dash, and GripGo grabs your phone ultra fast. That it peels right off. And don't worry, there's no sticky residue left behind. The 360-degree pivoting mount allows you to always get the perfect viewing angle. It's even strong enough to grab and hold this expensive smartphone out the window. Yet it comes right off with ease. That's the advantage of GripGo. You can get the amazing GripGo with dashboard mount for only $14.95. We'll send you a second kit free. Just pay separate processing and handling. Get 2 complete GripGo systems for just $14.95.
To order GripGo for $14.95 plus processing and handling, call 1-800-709-5259 or order online at getgripgo.com.
Finally, a Florida woman gives her new husband the most meaningful gift of all, life. Married just about a year ago, Melissa DeGueso Jones went under the knife this week to share one of her kidneys with her husband. James Jones has suffered his whole life with kidney disease. Melissa knew that in order to have a lifetime of love, he would need the life-saving surgery. The miracle was that the two were a perfect match.
We're compatible in love and then are now immunologically compatible as well, which is what makes this a unique situation, a beautiful story.
To be perfectly healthy and elect to have surgery. It shows the love and true compassion that one person can really have. And it will take me a lifetime of reciprocation. My wife's my hero.
Indeed. Now healthy, the two plan to finally take their honeymoon. Melissa wants Costa Rica. James wanted Fiji, but says Costa Rica it is. I would agree. That's going to do it for the CBN News Channel. You can find more of our exclusive coverage of the issues you care most about at cbnnews.com. Join us next time. Have a great day.
If you had a choice between going bald and a full head of hair, which would you choose? Advances in medical science have resulted in the world's first and only permanent solution to hair loss.
Yes!
You wash it, you cut it. It's your own real, naturally growing hair. When it comes to hair restoration, no one in the world has more experience than Bosley. The results look completely natural and are affordable on nearly any budget. But the entire process can't be explained in 60 brief seconds. So to find out more about this clinically proven and permanent solution to hair loss, call now to receive your free, no obligation information kit. It'll answer all of your questions about hair loss and hair restoration. Plus, we'll also send you this $250 gift certificate just for calling. Every day you wait, you're losing more hair. So don't put it off any longer. You owe it to yourself to find out the facts. Choose hair. Choose Bosley.
Call 800-868-9957. That's 800-868-9957.
Introducing the CBN Bible from CBN.com. Now, an easier way to study the Bible and grow in your faith. Highlight your favorite verse. Read separate versions at a glance. Click and read a commentary. Or cross-reference your favorite verse using the Strong's Concordance. All the right tools to study the Bible, all in one place. The CBN Bible, available at cbn.com/Bible or the iTunes App Store.